and give it to a bunch of insurance companies.
If we are serious about moving to cost-effective universal health care, yeah, we do have to take on the insurance companies.
What are you doing at this late hour to get the 50 votes you need to pass the bill?
We're going to press on. And it's okay to vote. It's okay to fall short, if you do, for an idea you believe in.
Would you support Democrats working with President Trump to cut a deal to try to fix problems with Obamacare?
Well, of course we would. We just want to make sure it helps people, like I laid out at the beginning. And the problem for me with the proposal that the Republicans, the umpteenth proposal we've seen on repeal, is that it actually hurts my state.
I'll sit down with anybody to talk about anything that matters as long as I think I got a chance to deliver. I believe climate change is real. Let's don't talk about it. Let's fix it. I think the DREAM Act kids deserve a place to stay and we secure our border. I'm even willing to do the minimum wage, Bernie, if we can find a tax cut that works. But what I'm not going to do is continue the same old crap and tell you everything is fine.
What the American people want is us to work together to build on and improve the Affordable Care Act, not repeal it.
Going to a single-payer system is not building upon and improving. It is basically saying it has failed and we shall do something else. That is what has been said. And I will go back. Who has the power? You, the state you live in, or the federal government?
So Senator McCain has talked about a better process. John, if you're listening, if we fall short, we'll try to have a better process. Nobody respects you more than I do. So to any American who's got a problem with John McCain's vote, all I can tell you is that John McCain was willing to die for this country, and he can vote any way he wants to, and it doesn't matter to me in terms of...